The month of Rajab, what is the prophetic tradition? What did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam do in this particular month? What is the significance of this month? And most importantly, how did Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam plan his Ramadan from the month of Rajab? Sheikh.
Alhamdulillahi wa kafa wa salamun ala ibadihi alladhina astafa la siyama al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallama tasliman kathira. Then after, the month of Rajab is one of four months which Allah the Almighty called them in the Quran in Surah At-Tawbah number 40. In Surah At-Tawbah chapter number 9, he called them Al-Ashhurul Hurum. So he said, إِنَّ عِدَّةَ الشُّهُورِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ 12 شَهْرًا فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ يَوْمَ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ مِنْهَا أَرْبَعَةٌ حُرُمٌ. So out of the 12 months which Allah created for us, lunar months of course, four of them are sacred and inviolable. What does it mean? He said, فَلَا تَظْلِمُوا فِيهِنَّ أَنفُسَكُمْ. So you should not wrong yourselves during these 4 months. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam explained that al-ashhur al-hurum, the four sacred months, are three consecutive: the month of Dhul-Qi'adah, Dhul-Hijjah, and the first month of the year, which is Muharram, and then the month of Rajab by itself, which falls between Jumada al-Awwal, and it is succeeded by the month of Sha'ban. So the month of Rajab is one of the four sacred months. Sacred in a sense that whatever a person does, whether of good deeds or bad deeds, the compensation for that will be doubled, maybe tripled, and even more. So the reward for the good deeds which are done during the month of Rajab or any of the four sacred months is multiple times than if it is done during any other time. And similarly, the person who deliberately commits a sin during this inviolable time, he will receive double the punishment for that sin because of the violation of the sacredness of this time. And that would lead us to discuss about how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, since He created the heavens and the earth and the time, He made some of the creation superior to others. He made some of the time superior to others. He made some of the places superior to others. So as far as the places, Mecca is the most superior place. And each ibadah, whether a prayer or otherwise, which is done in the Haram in Mecca, is better than 100,000 prayer, which is done anywhere else. Then Medina, which is also a Haram, okay? As far as the time, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us that إِنَّ مِنْ أَفْضَلِ أَيَّامِكُمْ, and in some hadith that إِنَّ أَفْضَلَ أَيَّامِكُمْ, which means the greatest day ever for Muslims, is the day of Friday. It's better than Thursday. It's better than any other day. And also the four sacred months, and also the month of Ramadan, where the gates of heaven will be open wide and the gates of hell will be shut down. So these are some indications that sometimes are superior to other times because of the mercy of Allah descending more during this time or in this place and so on. So the month of Rajab has these virtues. Yet, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did not prescribe any extra act of worship or a particular act of worship to be done exclusively in the month of Rajab more than what we normally do in any other month. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to fast on Mondays and Thursdays, likewise Rajab, but the reward is greater. He used to fast on 13th, 14th, and 15th of every lunar month, whether it is Safar, Muharram, Sha'ban, or Rajab. But the reward in Rajab is greater than Safar, Jumada, Al-Ula, or Al-Thaniya. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to pray a lot at night, and he used to recite Quran. So the regular acts of worship, that we used to do in the previous month or in the following month, we observe them in Rajab. To the extent that it's very, very famous how people recite a special supplication, which asking Allah to bless us during the month of Rajab, Sha'ban, and then enable us to attain the month of Ramadan. It's a beautiful dua. It's a beautiful supplication. If you recite it on your own, fine. But the fact of the matter, it's not a hadith. It's a very weak hadith. Okay? So we do not treat it as this is a prophetic prescription. We should say it whenever the month of Rajab approaches. It's a sacred month, but without a specifically prescribed act of worship exclusively for the month of Rajab.
Thank you.
And in a few days, people will be witnessing the 27th of Rajab. I want to emphasize Qamarul Islam. There is no special fasting on the day or a special Qiyamul Layl on that particular night whatsoever.